Good afternoon. My name is Ron Hunt, and I'm the chair of council here at Orleans United Church. And I want to wish a warm welcome to everybody that's here in the audience, as well as those people who are watching and listening online. We're so very pleased and honored to be able to host a second concert in the Five at the First Chamber Music Series. There are three pieces in today's program, including a world premiere. And how often do you get a chance to hear a world premiere? And Rachel will be introducing them as the concert unfolds. There will be some brief pauses in between some of the pieces to allow our audiovisual technicians to adjust the setup, because we're starting off with two musicians, then four, and then eight. So it gets a little bit tricky as things go along. So we ask for your patience while we do that. And finally, at the end of the concert, we ask that members of the audience that are present here to remain in your seats until an usher comes to your row. And the reason for that is this will allow us to kind of smooth out the flow of people and avoid congestion at the exits as you leave the church. And now, please put your hands together and welcome our first two artists, Rachel Mercer and Yosuke Kawasaki.
Thank you so much, Ron Hunt, and the whole team here at Orleans United, for all your work hosting this concert and creating the live stream for all of you watching at home. And thank you so much to the Ontario Arts Council for support of this concert. My name is Rachel Mercer, and I'm the artistic director of Five at the First Chamber Music Series in Hamilton, Ontario. And actually, we have our executive director, Michelle Corbet, who's driven in from Hamilton over there. So she's in the audience too. Thank you so much, Michelle, for being here. This concert is a musical celebration of life and friendship. It is dedicated to a man that we all hold in our hearts, Yehonatan Berick, violinist, violist, and professor at the University of Michigan, until he moved around 2011, 2013, with his family to the Ottawa area, to actually Orleans. And he later became professor of violin at the University of Ottawa. And he is an important part of the lives of everyone on stage today in various ways. And I know many of you here and also watching online. Yehonatan passed away from cancer just over 1 year ago. Earlier that year, we had planned these concerts close to home, along with our friends and colleagues, Yosuke and Jessica. And he and I even came to the church a year ago and we tried out the piano, so we're gonna have concerts with piano also. So we play today's concert, thinking of him in a musical celebration of our shared connection in the spirit of friendship and love for music. The first piece you will hear is the world premiere of Intuitions No. 2, a duo for violin and cello by Kevin Lau. Kevin is one of the most sought-after Canadian composers today and has written large-scale works such as the ballet Le Petit Prince with the choreographer Guillaume Côté for the National Ballet, and many chamber and solo works, including on Juno-winning albums. Kevin was commissioned in 2020 by Jonathan Krem to write this duo for Yehonatan and myself, and it is now dedicated to him. And Yosuke joins me for its premiere today. Kevin writes about the piece. With the intuitions, I was drawn to the idea of creating a set of spur-of-the-moment pieces, something I have rarely ever done, except while improvising privately. This particular piece embraces a kind of exploratory dialogue between the violin and cello. The dialogue is at times passionate, at other times playful, unfolding like a dance that flickers back and forth between multiple traditions, but with the partners always in step with one another. The piece was inspired by and is dedicated to Yehonatan and Rachel and the dance that they created together.
Thank you.
The next piece is by the Cuban-American alto saxophonist, clarinet, and composer, Paquito de Rivera. He was born in 1948. And he wrote this piece, the Village Street Quartet, in 2000 for the Ying Quartet. And I'm just going to read what he wrote about it, because it's so great. It just tells you everything. He writes, "When I moved to New York in 1980, taking a walk around a Greenwich Village Street fair in the early summer, I was fascinated by the smell of the ethnic foods sold by dozens of peddlers from the most various regions of the world, and especially by the variety of music played on the sidewalks by street musicians. Among them, in the middle of Washington Square Park, I found a string quartet formed by an African-American cellist, an Asian viola player, and a married couple of violinists." Oh. But she from Eastern Europe and her Puerto Rican husband. In their repertoire, they played works from Bach to Gershwin to Piazzolla by way of Cuban danzas, Brazilian music, polkas, and Middle Eastern music. Even though I have used the string quartet on a few occasions, the Village Street, which written especially for the wonderful Ying Quartet, is my first serious approach to this format. In that case, it was my desire to recreate in the piece the multicultural atmosphere that I breathed for the first time so many years ago in this picturesque New York neighborhood.
Thank you. Thank you. This is a special version, though, because we have Joel Quarrington playing the second cello part on bass.
And I think, for me, it's one of the biggest thrills to play it in this version. So we hope you will enjoy it, and I'd like to welcome all my colleagues to the stage. Thank you.